I think I had the very first talk today where I want to set the stage a bit here, what we want to do at Nextcloud, what's different to other projects and to other software, what we have available today already at Nextcloud 10, and what's coming in the future. So let's get started. The agenda is, I want to talk a little bit about the Nextcloud vision, but not too much, because I assume that most of you know it already, otherwise you wouldn't be here, but just a little bit what we want to achieve. And then I want to answer the question that I heard most the last few months, what is different here? What is different with Nextcloud? Then something that a lot of people ask us, what's going into the next release? Because Nextcloud is not a classic proprietary closed source software product where a company develops everything and then boom, here's the next release. It's a little bit different here. I want to explain how this works. Then a brief overview of what's new and cool in Nextcloud 10 already, which is already out, as you know, and then what's coming for 11 and the future. And then hopefully we still have time for more questions. So could someone watch the clock a bit and tell me if I'm using too much time? Okay. Which is likely. Okay, well, thanks. Okay, so what is the Nextcloud vision? The Nextcloud vision is that we want to enable users and organizations to take back control over their data and communication. As you know, there's a huge trend going on in the industry. Cloud computing, right, which means basically outsourcing infrastructure and data and applications to other entities, and that's a good thing. That's a good thing. But it's important that the users and the organizations and the companies and the universities are still in control of the data, so they have a choice. So they can decide to pay like Amazon. To provide them some infrastructure, but if they no longer like infrastructure at Amazon, they should be able to move into somewhere else. That's very important. So this is what we do, with data and with communication. Okay, so what do we need for this vision? First of all, it should be very easy to host wherever you want. So obviously, it's super important that you can deploy and run it very easily wherever you want. And this is a very small installation, like Raspberry Pi, up to big clusters for 100,000 and millions of users. There shouldn't be any data silos, so there should be no lock-in effect. If you decide to use some infrastructure, some service, whatever, then you should always be able to move it out of this system and move it somewhere else. No data silos. Scaling from small to huge. Like I said, that's very important. The user experience is very key. We hear this a lot from our users and customers that they really like what you're doing because it's so easy and nice to use. Right? But if we're honest to ourselves, most of the features that you can do with Nextcloud, there's probably also some cryptic command line tool somewhere which can do something similar. But of course, no one's using it because you can't do it. So user experience is super, super important for us. Flexibility to integrate. Most of you who already run Nextcloud have integrated with some other system, some authentication, some storage, some monitoring, some logging, something. So integration is very important. It should be cross-platform. So this should work on Mac, Windows, Linux, iOS, and Android. And of course, security. I mean, security is not optional. This is the key of everything. If the solution is not secure, then why do it in the first place? Security is too important. Okay. So, but another thing that's very important is if all of you run your own Nextcloud installation somewhere, that's great. But then we have a lot of isolated islands. And this is, of course, then different to the big cloud installations out there, where everybody, everywhere, can collaborate. So this is what we want to achieve with our federation concept. So here's a little picture where we have different Nextcloud servers here in the middle, and you have different users using this service. And this one of it can be at your university, another one could be in your company, another can be your Raspberry Pi at home or your service provider somewhere, it doesn't matter. With the federation concept, you can actually share and communicate between different servers, some kind of server-server communication. And that's a very key mission and feature for us, because only then we can basically turn this centralized cloud computing world into a peer-to-peer world, where there's no central server, but there are different servers that can offer. Okay, so this is a brief overview of what we want to achieve. Let's talk a little bit about what we do different. So, this is something that so many people, customers, prospects, journalists, everybody asks us, hey, there's Nextcloud now, that's new, and they're great, but what is different? There should be something different. Nothing is different than this, no news, right? So what is different? Okay, first of all, that's the most important thing. What is different is that we want to listen to feedback. We want to listen to feedback that people give us. And this could come from customers, from prospects, from partners, from community users, from developers. So we see Nextcloud as something that is as open as absolutely possible. So we want to listen to what you need, what you want, and this should fold in what we do. There are different ways to do that. First of all, event like that, because what I said, we want to hear feedback. But we're also looking at other ways to get more feedback. For example, Nextcloud 10, we have a new feature developed by Björn here, where users can optionally report back to us what apps they're using, what database they're using, how many user files they have, how many shares they have, and so on. This is optional, and this helps us understand a little bit more how we use them. Then we have a new platform called help.nextcloud.com. That's a very nice platform to do discussions and to collaborate together. That's another thing. And we want to do more and more where we can listen to you. Okay, and I think we listened the last few months, and what we heard is basically you can condense this to those four things. Here is you should focus more on reliability and on production use. And Nextcloud shouldn't be something that's just for hackers or for home users. We are running this in a serious production environment with 100,000 of users with 99.99% uptime and should be scaled. This is really, really important. So please focus on that. Then what we also hear is security. You should make sure that it's really, really secure. Then scalability and performance. I mean, Nextcloud is not slow and it can scale, but I think all of your installations are growing and you all want to be sure that you don't hit any scalability limits here. So this is something that you have to work on. And openness. A lot of people ask us, hey, can you please be more transparent with your bug fix releases, the problems you fix, the security you fix, your roadmap, and so on and so on. And we also want to do that. So let's go through all those things. What we improve here. First, the production tools. One thing we changed in Nextcloud is that Nextcloud is supported up to 10 years. So if you buy commercial support from us, Nextcloud GMH, we support your instance up to 10 years. This is significantly more than 1.5 years that you get somewhere else. This is really important. I can tell you so many stories that people came to us and say, okay, this is service running great, I have no problem, there are no bugs, it's really fast. I don't want to upgrade the pain, I have 3,500 users and user interface changes, and I don't want to upgrade, but I have to upgrade because my version, I have deployed is 1.5 years old and it's no longer supported. And that's the pain. So with Nextcloud, if you're happy with your installation, with your feature set, with everything the software does, you can run it for up to 10 years. Next thing is, with Nextcloud 10, you already added a monitoring backend. So you can monitor Nextcloud with Nagios or OpenNMS to see see that it's working and how it's working, how many users are registered, how many users are active at the moment, how many shares are there, how many files are there, and so on. So you can all type it into a nice Nagios dashboard and you can see how your incident is running and what's going on. So this is obviously very important. The third thing is that's a major one. So Nextcloud is 100% open source. So Nextcloud is 100% HTTP/HTTP. This is very important. Why do I say this in the topic production focus? This is very important because there is no vendor lock-in. If you like what we are doing, you can take our software. By the way, there's only one software. That's the community edition, enterprise edition. That's only one software. Take it, install it, run it. You can do this forever without any cost, and it's all the enterprise features. If you want professional support, you can come to us and we can sell you the support. At some point, if you decide that you no longer want the support, you just stop paying us for the support. This doesn't change that you always have the software, you can always run the software. With other solutions, you have to basically, if you rely on enterprise features, then you can no longer pay, then you lose the right to use it. It's basically the same as with proprietary. It's basically proprietary code. We are open source. The next thing is that when we structured our new company, we structured it in a way that there is no clear cut between the engineers who do the code and the support people who fix the bugs and talk to the customers. These are the same people. I mean, obviously, we have maybe some people with coordination or something, or route questions in the right channels, sure. But you get direct access to engineers who wrote the code in the first place. So we are really confident that we can deliver you really good support that you that is worth the money for you. Okay, and second thing is security. I think I'm already running this date on the time. And I want to very briefly talk about it because there's a great talk to Lucas coming up later today. But security is a very important thing for us, and we already invested in that. For example, we already have a brute force protection in place. So Nextcloud 10 already has a feature where you can contact brute force your passwords, and this is simple script test standard passwords. So that's already blocked. That's also on your way. Then scalability and performance. So what we do is we have ongoing automatic performance tests. So if we change the code, we always test it if it has a performance regression. It's very important. We already have load database load by some great work from Robin over there. So it's already improved and it's ongoing. So you make it faster all the time. It's not like other software that gets slower, but we're working on improved object store, multi-bucket support, and we're working on a very innovative new storage cluster solution that I don't want to talk too much at the moment. There will be some really cool news in the next few months. Really, basically, pushes scalability of Nextcloud to a complete new level. That's coming in the next few months. And then a few general remarks. What is different here? Well, we don't rely on external expertise. We basically have all the key expertise in our organization, so we can really deliver the support you want. We are a bit of a boring German company. We don't have fancy VCs or other external investment or great IPO or exit plans. So we are doing this when basically we all decided to do that together, the core group, we decided that, look, this is something, an organization, company we want to build together that we can work in like the next 10, 20, 30 years. So the whole setup of what we're doing is built for sustainability. We don't plan to have any external investment, we don't want to sell to anyone. This is something we want to build for our own, for the foreseeable future, which also, I think, gives you some certainty that what we're doing is still in the way that we're doing it. The last thing is, you can go to GitHub. On GitHub, you can see, look at nice charts and statistics. And then you can see if you compare the development momentum of Nextcloud to other projects, then we see that we are significantly ahead and moving a lot faster than others, which I also think is very important, because it means that you will get in the near future the better features, the better bug fixes, the better improvements. Okay, then I want to talk a little bit what's going into a next cloud release. So if this is a release, this blog is a release, let's say the next cloud 11 or 12 or something, then, as I said, we are not a standard classic company where basically we do all the work and at some point we upgrade to a new version, that's it. Actually, from this release, only a part, and I wouldn't say 50%, it's like, just to explain it better, only a part is actually done by employees of the Nextcloud GmbH, our company. A big part is done by others. It's very special because we have this commercial software that. Okay, who are others? I think you can split this up into contributors, volunteers. So we have a lot of people out there who just contribute code because they like it, they use it themselves, they want to fix something, they have an idea. We have really a lot of contributors who just work on the software together with us. Another thing is that partners and customers also sometimes decide to work on Nextcloud. So maybe they have their own developers. I just heard from Frederick that you're hiring like two people, I think.
We're looking for two people, yeah.
Yeah. So you want to, you are hiring developers to work on Nextcloud.
Yes.
And this is really interesting, right? You don't have this somewhere else. You don't hire developers to improve Windows. That's not possible. And this is what you can do here. This is really great. Okay, and then I'll talk about the Nextcloud. What do we do here? What do we do here? Well, we can also split this up. You can say, well, we have our own roadmap. We have our ideas, we have our vision, and we also have our, we want to do certain things for the expertise, and we just do it. But there are other ways to get new features into the next release too. First of all, you can come to us and say, hey, I really want this feature, and I want to do a consulting project with you guys. Can you please build this feature? And then you build this feature for you. And there's something new coming. That's not ready yet, but in the next few months, also together with our federal foundation that we're going to launch, there will be a way to formally vote on certain features from customers and partners. That can basically, you can now decide what you want to have in the next release. And then we promise to also implement that in the next issue. So you want to be really open. Okay. But let's talk a little bit.
Yeah. You say questions in between. If so many people contribute to each of your sources, how do you guarantee the support mode where they were direct, we pay for direct contact to the developers?
Yes.
You support outside code.
Yeah. So that's an excellent question. The thing is that Nextcloud is not a monolithic code base. It's like it has a core and then content connects. They're basically plugins. And the way it usually works is a lot of contributors that start to work on apps or plugins. They can publish it on our app store, people can use it and person gets experience to the conference and gets more basically sucked into the core code. At the beginning it's an optional feature, which we probably won't support. We don't support all the apps out there, we only support like base part. But then if this developer basically then gets more and more familiar with what we're doing, he might even like do significant changes in the core tool. So for example, one of the big features I'm talking about later is a new app store that we're going to launch in the next version. This is done by Bernhard, he's a volunteer. He just started doing this free time. But he's someone that we worked together for many, many years. You know him quite well, we have a very good relationship. In this case, we can absolutely support him. That was a review process. So I agree, if a random person from someone will come and does the core change, it's really big, it would be a problem. But this is probably not the problem.
What do you mean by customers? Those people using Nextcloud or as you are paying customers, you pay for the support?
I mean here? That's a good point. Actually, they don't have to be customers, it's all going to be just institutional users. Obviously, you don't need a support contract with us to be able to work on those features. It could be anything.
Another question we have. You talk about cloning.
Yes.
I'm a person who paid for the support.
Yes.
Is my vote more worth to you? And then again, maybe I have 100,000 users. Do I have to ask them to vote?
That's the exact question. The exact model is not finalized yet. But this year, this is something where we basically commit developers from us. We pay developers. This is like paid developers. We pay developers to work on a certain feature. So this load is, yes, if you're a customer, then you have a bigger load than someone else, yes.
With customer, you mean it's support?
Yes. Yeah. I mean, we can't, I mean, this is an investment from us. We invest like resource into this feature. So this is basically all the influence that you get if you have a support contract. But you don't need it, right? You can also do it yourself, or hire us to do it, or hire someone else to do it. It's also possible. And it's the same review process, right? It's a pull request about people to use it, it's in. There's no additional barrier. But yes, if you want us to do a feature that's, by the way, not on our roadmap, it's on our roadmap we do it anyways. But this is for features that are very, maybe only important for you. Yes, it helps if you're a customer. Okay, Nextcloud 10. So this is the already released version that's already out there. So what's improved? Improvements are in the server monitoring, as I said before. So we have like a nice page and diagram and the page where you can see CPU load and memory load and so on. And we have to monitor endpoints for the targets, open and database. We have done the root loss protection that we can't have passwords and other uses easily. Two-factor authentication is really, really a big feature, so it's very flexible. Already works with the Google authenticator and, for example, Google, and there's more coming up with hardware support in the future. Improved firewall level and shibboleth support. One of you relies on several of shibboleth. That's another feature which is open source here. We have a simple theming feature, so on the admin page you can just upload your logo and change your name and the color, and then it's already themed. So that's also a popular feature. The federated sharing, but you will talk about it later, but we have some improvements here. And all enterprise apps are open source. That's all I'm telling you. Okay, another improvement is the Collabora online integration, so working together with Collabora, online office, LibreOffice integration, so you can edit your documents in the browser, you can view them, you can edit them, and also in a limited way collaboratively, but there are basically mobile launching versions so you can also fully collaboratively work by editing the documents here. And this works with office documents and LibreOffice. Another thing is our voice video integration. So as you might know, when we founded Nextcloud, we did this together with Popper, who developed a Street Me technology that we have now, that we are integrating with Nextcloud at the moment. So if you use Nextcloud, you have the WebRTC based video conferencing already integrated. So with all these improvements and that we implemented, that we already had in the past, that we added here. I think it's safe to say that Nextcloud 10 is really at the moment the most advanced software in our space. So there is no other software which has similar functionality. And it's all open source. So there's no enterprise model here on the software license side. So the enterprise model for us is that we want to say just support you that we do not qualify, but the software doesn't know.
I have two questions. The first would be about the roadmap for version 10. Do you know which date you have a target?
That's easy to answer, it's already out. Well, you can download it today.
The 10 is already out.
And it's already out. Everything I showed you earlier is you can use it today. Download from our website.
And the second one is, you say you support systems for 10 years?
Yes.
How can I get that? I mean, you have a base system, how do you plan to put that pretty long time span?
Not sure. I'm
like fixing the systems, or
for
what exactly you have support that?
Yeah, so support means that we have a stage model with bug fixes and support that we do. In the first year, we are actively backporting and fixing problems in older versions that we found. But if they get older and older, especially close to 10 years, then support means that we help you with serious data loss bugs. So if there's a bug that's serious, people can lose data, for example, or with security issues. We fix security issues. We don't actively basically polish 10-year-old software. So if it's really that old, then it's serious data loss bugs and security bugs only.
Do you use like PHP?
Yes.
And so if PHP gets outdated and if you can say this version is not supported anymore, you wouldn't support it anyway.
No, so the idea is that if you today install a server, the operating system you choose, with the PHP version you choose, with the database you choose, and with the current Nextcloud version, and you install all of that, and it works, and you're happy with that, then you're happy from our perspective to run the system up to 10 years. We don't do the operating system support or the database support. We also need someone who supports the database for 10 years or can get it for forever if you want. And they also do long-term support for PHP versions. But this is not what we do. We support Nextcloud. We need to buy support for your other components somewhere else.
Sorry?
Yeah.
The support stuff, you wrote 5 plus 5, but it means first 5 and second 5.
Yeah, that's the pricing.
Okay, yes. Right. A normal open source versions will be 1 paper, 1.5 year, or how long will stay next up then?
We do regular security fixes, of course, but support in this context also means that you can call us and say, I have a problem here, we debug it together with you, and then we fix it, provide you a patch. We don't do that to share our customer. You're free to open an issue of GitHub, discuss the forum with others, but that's up to you.
But your patches will go back into...
Yeah. Okay. So next log and levels. As I said before, that's a bit not 100% clear what the exact feature set will be, because that's not my decision. And if you decide to contribute something, then it also goes in. And if some contributors out there also work right, an interesting feature also goes in. But these are our ideas. So the idea is to do the Nextcloud 11 release at the end of the year. And we're already working on a few interesting features, and we have app-specific permissions. Also done by Robin here, which improves the the security significantly. Then we have really, really cool federation improvements. This is what Björn will show you later today. This is really nice. Really, really excited about that. We have the video voice conferencing integration. I mean, I showed you earlier that we already works today, but it's not fully integrated yet. We're working on that. We have like contact integrated, address book integrated, and so on. Native chat and email integration, working on really nice scalability improvements, update reliability. That's a really important. A lot of people complain that upgrading, updating Nextcloud is sometimes painful to work on that. It will be possible to skip major versions. And we have a new app store, which makes distribution of third-party apps a lot more easier, nicer, more stable. So these are the improvements that we plan to do for the next feature development. Then I also had a slide about Nextcloud 12, but that's obviously very, very vague. This comes like next year. We want to work on token-based logins for all clients. With the latest version, we only implemented a token-based authentication that can lock out certain devices, but it needs to have support for other clients. More group integration, a lot of people say, hey, we need that integration with some, I don't know, school out or exchange or exchange Microsoft. And then we think that at this point we have the video and voice experience developed so far that we can call it a full Skype experience. That I can start from my phone, call someone else on the phone, call a video call, and this goes through our service. And then the last point, most important, tell us what we need. What we need today, in the next few days, we have a good discussion. What you want to see in software, and together we can make it happen. So to summarize it, I think we have a really huge development momentum. Like if you follow the development of GitHub, our side, you see that we really have a lot of people with a lot of enthusiasm, with a lot of cool things coming in. That's a huge momentum here. I think we have the idea and vision. We have the core people, most of the core developers from some other projects moved to our project, at least. And I think we have a good way to work together with you guys to hear your input. And I think together we can keep on innovating and pushing this forward. Thanks a lot.
Very, very important to use the open source
strategy, because the next goal is always if there's already an API that people use, then use it. For example, that's the reason we use Webcloud. We could have come up with our own protocol, but that makes no sense, that open standard use it. For the federation part, federation did still use pieces, there's actually file transfer part, we also use Webcloud for that. And then there is some communication part where you can invite people on servers, they get share requests, confirm it or not. So there's some exchange going on, and for that part, there was no API. This is completely new. So Björn and I, like 3 years ago, or two and a half, developed this API together. Then later, more people like the Lucas, for example, helped with it, also to document it. We worked together with other projects like Kaio, for example, in France. They also implemented this API, also with the help of Lucas here. And we want to make this a standard. We're working in the Xi'an organization at the moment, with other organizations together, also pointing out to make this a standard. That will be actually called next week to work with it. I'm also a member of a WS3C working group. We are also pushing this forward. So obviously, to make it a real standard is an ongoing, long-running process. But this is fully documented, there's a full open source reference implementation. We are actually actively implementing this in our project. IBM technically is a competitor, but we still implement it on their side because we really want to make this a standard. And there's a lot more to be coming.
More organizational. Yeah, the little clients on the size that you see today.
Sure. Then I guess we move to the next talk.
Yes.
Yeah.